This is my 6th chai today. Welcome to Turkey. Woohoo!
Many world tour cyclists name Turkey as their favorite country. Why is that? Well, in today's episode, we try to figure out if Turkey is really that good for long-distance bicycle touring. No, not that Turkey. Turkey the country. To make this a very serious, if not a scientific video, we even came up with 10 categories of utmost importance, but in no particular order.
Due to our superior knowledge and some hindsight, after cycling all the way from Germany to Turkey and roughly 2000 kilometers through it, we will carefully rank each category in a 100% objective way.
But first we need to get to Tire, where we will meet Çiğdem and Adam, our first Warm Showers host since Sicily.
See, that car slows down because he can't pass us safely, so he just slows down and waits until he can pass us with proper distance. That's fantastic. Feels really, really safe cycling here. Even though there's no cycling lanes, is it because they're just used to the fact that the road is for everyone? Like being the people who are walking, the farmer with his tractor, or a cyclist, motorcyclist, whatever. Let us know in the comments below.
So, road safety gets 8 out of 10, because of course not building a road that has no headwind is a clear oversight that could have been easily avoided. And please, always watch out for slower traffic, especially during rush hour.
After a windy 42-kilometer ride, we reached Tire just to face more serious problems.
We're trying to buy toilet paper for a couple of days now. And in Turkey, they have this bag with 16, this is a small one, only 8, 16, what's this, 32, really, yeah.
These locations are all Tire.
Going to get ourselves some fresh produce. We saw a lot of artichokes growing in the area. Look at that amount of greens here. All sorts of fresh herbs, not only like parsley and dill. Fresh thyme, rosemary, artichokes, tomato plants, everything you can imagine. Real cucumbers. All are cranky, very thin, very flavorful, not the standardized, industrial grown.
Böyle, bak. Siz nereye geldiniz abi, farkında mısınız? Nereye geldiniz?
Turkey will be a feast for us. Look at this.
Erik ne kadar?
15. How are they called?
In Turkish, Erik.
Biz İzmir'e bile gidemeyiz. Bunlar yurt dışından geliyorlar bak.
Evet, bisikletle.
Bisikletle
geliyorlar. Süre süre.
Look at the local cheese. Different types of cream cheese. This is almost like powder cheese. Very interesting. There's a lot to discover. A lot to discover in Turkey, culinarily.
It smells great.
Thanks to the thoughtful, wise, and in no way corrupt and autocratic leadership over the last 2 decades, Turkey features a staggering inflation rate, officially averaging over 70% throughout 2022. Economy very bad, we hear a lot. While tourists love shopping in the country, this situation is extremely challenging for most locals.
All that sightseeing left us a little hungry, so our hosts led us to their favorite sandwich shop, where we definitely had just one very tasty and crunchy sucuk and cheese sandwich.
Oh, cut the crap. Of course we had a second one. Fortunately for hungry cyclists, Turkey has an eating out culture, and therefore many ready-to-eat calories are usually not far, but the variety could be better.
So, 7 out of 10. Our stay with Çiğdem and Adam was wonderful. Just because we might cycle Australia in the future, they even packed all their things and moved down under, only to eventually be able to host us again.
That's just great, and so we award 11 out of 10 points for Turkish hospitality.
Onwards to the east. Now I think it's about 40 kilometers pretty flat, and then we start climbing.
1200.
Yeah, the total climb on our route to Pamukkale, which is our next bigger destination, is 1200 meters, and just go east in Turkey and enjoy the kindness of the people and the beauty of the country. Come with us.
It is May and we already struggle with the heat.
We were thinking about subtracting 10 points, but some smarty pants would surely argue that we went in the wrong time of the year, right?
I don't know if you could see this, but there was like a mini baby tornado or something.
It's around 12 o'clock here and it got really hot, so we found a cafe and want to drink some tea, a hot tea. It's not surprising to do that here in Turkey. It doesn't matter how hot it is outside, you always drink chai.
Back on the road after 3 hours of lunch and heat break from 12 a.m. to 3 p.m. Other than that, nothing really changed. We're just continuing our trip as expected.
I think we need to find a shelter.
Wow. So we'll try to climb a little bit up the mountain before we put our tent in a hopefully dry place.
8% gradient. Luckily, luckily it rained, so it's not so hot anymore. It's a little bit, yeah, it's humid obviously, but better than like 30 degrees.
Finding a safe and flat spot free of charge is generally negatively correlated with population density. But of course, countless factors go into this. We find that talking to locals can help.
Obviously, with the house, house, house, buraya.
Thank you so
much. No problem. No.
Thanks to these nice people and of course our impressive freestyle sign language skills, we could set up our tent in this beautiful place with a great view on 2 villages close by.
Overall, we give 8 out of 10 for wild camping in Turkey. And that has absolutely nothing to do with the free and very reliable wake-up service around 5 a.m. one can enjoy almost everywhere.
Especially in a country with a rather warm climate like Turkey, staying hydrated is a priority. There can be days when our water consumption is over 5 liters per person for drinking only. Fortunately, they place water fountains or çeşme almost everywhere.
So, 9 out of 10.
First proper mountain since ever. The interesting thing is, to me, even though it seems like struggling up the mountains, and it is, I'm struggling really bad. It's so rewarding, like even while struggling. You see all that nature, you breathe super clean air, the pine trees behind us, you hear the birds singing, it's amazing.
Turkey is a pretty big country with a lot of nature and beautiful landscapes. If you like this view, wait until we get further east.
10 out of 10.
That looks like we
arrived at the highest point. Hopefully, from now on, no more climbing. It's over 100 kilometers to Pamukkale. We will not be able to get to Pamukkale today, but we'll try to get as far as we can. And now we'll be enjoying 15 kilometers descent down the mountain. Okay, so let's go.
Do you guys like Matthias' mustache?
What's not to like about this? So, I will get a haircut because apparently he approached me, so he thinks it's really necessary. Let me know what you think. Maybe it's true. We'll see how it looks afterwards.
The level of friendliness in a country is of course a function of how many times per day you are invited for tea, times share of all cars honking to greet you over distance traveled. By that measure, Turkey likely is one of the friendliest places you can ride your bicycle in. Look, they even gave me a new facial hairstyle.
Okay, we try mustache. I was not a big fan.
Jimmy, let's go!
Going down from about, I don't know, 900 or something.
Yes, I'm sure.
This is one of my favorite and famous shortcuts, where it's where the way is actually longer. The road surface is horrible, but we are not on the main road, so it's much more enjoyable, right? Right? Uh-huh. Right?
Especially right now.
Yeah, I was a big fan of sandy surfaces. Rah! Rah!
Go, go, go!
What kind of meeting is this?
La Deutsche, Denizli.
Denizli exchange, hotel.
Denizli, no hotel. Friend.
Yeah. Gel buraya.
Slippery.
Hadi. Hadi bir adım daha lan.
No.
Gidiyorum.
Oh, very good.
You.
Whoa. You made it. We changed our plans. We are not going to Pamukkale first because we have a host Murat in Denizli. So we go first to Denizli, and on the way we pass Laodicea.
Yeah, it's an ancient city.
Will be impressive for sure.
How are we going?
Map says cross here. Okay. Sun is scorching. It's not even like it's 11 o'clock or something. 32 degrees already. Hello.
Asia Minor has been settled for thousands of years, and so modern day Turkey is stuffed with epic ancient cities and landmarks. Last episode we just left Ephesus, and now just 4 days of cycling and about 230 kilometers later we are at the next impressive pile of very old stones, Laodicea.
So overall we can award a staggering grand total of 84 out of 100 points, which catapults Turkey at the very top of our extensive leaderboard. This is very impressive, and all jokes aside, we think it's a great country to do some serious bike touring. Of course, everyone's experience will be different and unique. If you like this video, please be so kind and give it a thumbs up. More people will be able to find us, and we might eventually break even from Google AdSense.
A little stressful, we get a nice snowy ice for Adolf and me.
Thank you so much for watching, and of course a special mention of our amazing supporters on buymeacoffee.com/aworldbiketour.
Next up are the travertines of Pamukkale and the historic Greek city of Hierapolis, which are just around the corner.
Until next time, and may the wind be in your back.